I'm on a ride along in El Cajon with HomeStart, a nonprofit agency that offers wraparound services for people experiencing homelessness. We get a firsthand look, a raw look at the challenges that face social workers and also the people living on the street.
We have a client to see. He's usually over by Salvation Army.
We hit the road with Karina Hernandez and her team from HomeStart.
Really want to make a difference, you know, in the community.
We stop and meet up with Cecil and his pup, Bob, who've been waiting for housing for 3 years.
I got approved for an apartment, but they didn't inspect it in time, and they kicked my application out before 2 days before my move-in date.
He was on a voucher program that's run by the county. Now Cecil's in HomeStart's coordinating entry system in hopes of getting a housing match, but it's not a guarantee.
It's a housing opportunity that could come up, and you get matched to different agencies, including HomeStart.
Encampments have been illegal in El Cajon long before other cities started passing bans. Hotel vouchers are more difficult to come by here as well.
So we do partner well with El Cajon Police Department.
This alley often gets filled with encampments, but was recently cleared out. We found some of those that were living there now shifted a block away to a bus stop on East Main.
But are you interested in enrolling in an outreach service so that we can connect and start building that relationship and try to get you some housing options?
Now, there is the East County Transitional Living Center, which is a temporary shelter, but not everyone wants to go. That's where HomeStart comes in to start the process of finding housing and building connections to be a familiar face.
Hi, Mr. Foley.
HomeStart says the burden to help the 800 or more people experiencing homelessness in El Cajon is starting to get lighter.
East County is kind of still known as a resource desert, but other agencies are coming out here seeing that the need is needed here for additional resources for these individuals to hopefully get off the streets.
I spoke to El Cajon Mayor Bill Wells, who says that they're in early discussions to welcome a Rescue Mission Navigation Center, which is a 30-day emergency transitional shelter.
It is like true that we house somebody and someone else will become homeless.
Even as the need grows.
Like I said, if you need transportation or anything like that.
A little persistence in some TLC.
Need some dog food? Yeah. Did you want any snacks for yourself?
HomeStart says it's not giving up and it wants the community to see another side of homelessness a little clearer.
You become some kind of hope for somebody.
In El Cajon.
Bye.
Abby Black, bye. CBS 8.